I don't know what it is about 2021 where a lot of rappers in rap music are passing away in their 50s, but it is just ridiculous. So, I'm sure you all obviously know the sad news from Friday. Legendary rapper Biz Markie, who was born as Marcel Theo Hall on April 8th, 1964 in Harlem, New York, passed away on July 16th at the age of 57 in Baltimore, Maryland, due to complications of diabetes. Now, I remember on July 1st that there were rumors saying that he passed away, but they were not true, thank God, as he was still under medical care. And I was glad that he was okay, because when I heard about the rumors saying that he had passed away, I was like, okay, it's bad enough we lost DMX, Black Rob, and Shock G in the same month of April. I do not want another legendary rapper in Biz Markie passing away as well. So thank God that Biz Markie did not pass away at that time on July 1st. Thank God. But then all of a sudden, I found out on Friday that Biz Markie this time passed away. It was no rumor this time. It was no hoax or anything. Unfortunately, Biz Markie this time passed away, as his wife was by his side. He was nicknamed the Clown Prince of Hip Hop, and Biz Markie was funny and he was known for his humor. He released 5 studio albums. He released his first 2 albums in the late 80s, 1988 and 89, his 3rd and 4th album in the 90s, 1991 and 1993, and his last studio album was back in 2003. Titled Weekend Warrior. Biz Markie is known for his song, Just a Friend. The song was about Markie's lyrics describing romantic frustration after pursuing a woman who was actually romantically involved with another man, who she falsely claims, oh, he's just a friend. And of course, in that same song, that's when Biz Markie will reply back saying, don't give me that. Don't give me that. Like, he's not buying it. Yeah, right. He's not falling for the banana in the tailpipe. And also known for his chorus, oh, baby, you got what I need. Well, she says he's just a friend. Well, she says he's just a friend. Obviously, Biz Markie's chorus was not all that great. I mean, he wasn't a very good singer when singing the chorus, but you still felt the pain when he was singing the chorus. You still felt it. Just a Friend is a romantic love song. Rappers back then actually used to have songs about love. I mean, besides LL Cool J. I mean, LL Cool J is pretty much the king of love songs. When it comes to I Need Love, Hey Lover featuring Boyz II Men, Love You Better. But you had other rappers that has songs about love. Nowadays, rappers, especially in the mainstream, with all this cookie cutter, mumbo jumbo, mumbling crap, they don't have love songs anymore. I mean, the only songs where it mentions about love is their love for vagina and their love for money and stuff like that, and their love for having sex. I mean, I bet these rappers nowadays probably think it'll be a weak move for them to make love songs about women that they have feelings for. No, it doesn't make you weak. There's nothing wrong for rappers to make love songs. If LL Cool J, Biz Markie, and other rappers can do it, why not you? Grow up here and just make love songs. I mean, the last time I remember a love song by a rapper was by Soulja Boy, Kiss Me Through the Phone. You know, that song was about how Soulja Boy misses his girlfriend and, you know, he would kiss her through the phone. They would kiss each other through the phone, telling each other they love and miss each other. And so that's a great message for the song. But the song is still corny and weak because Soulja Boy just sucks at rapping. His rapping ruins the freaking song. The chorus is fine, whoever sings the song, but it's just Soulja Boy's rapping, it ruins it. This is you, public. Blah, 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 blah. He just sounds, he just sounds like he's not even trying. You ruined the song. You ruined your own song, Soulja Boy. Oh, and then there's Lil Wayne with his high life, High Life. Yeah, yeah. He says that's supposed to be a love song, but that love song is weak too. But besides Just a Friend, he also has songs like Vapors, Spring Again.
Yes, Spring Again.
He also premiered in Men in Black 2. He was also one of the guests on the live-action puppet educational musical children's television series Yo Gabba Gabba. They used to air on Nickelodeon, part of the Nick Jr. block. But yeah, he was hospitalized due to severe complications from type 2 diabetes since last year in April 2020. Like I said, it's bad enough that we lost DMX, Black Rob, Shock G in the month of April. 3 months later, Biz Markie is gone. We have lost four legendary rappers in rap. It's like, enough is enough. Like, I really hope and pray that for the rest of the year, there won't be any more legendary rappers passing away. Because we lost four. Okay, four is enough. It's like, we don't want any more legendary hip-hop legends passing away for the rest of this year. It's just too much. Rest in peace to Marcel Theo Hall, a.k.a. known as Biz Markie. Rest in peace, Biz. You'll be missed. And also, I remember when Biz Markie was alive, he was considered as one of the ugliest rappers of all time. I mean, I remember TMZ were talking about, they were trying to name who was like the ugliest rappers of all time. And he also included Biz Markie and KRS-One and all of them. I'm like, yo, why are you guys having discussion about who's the ugliest rappers of all time? Who cares about Biz Markie's appearance? The point is, the man made some good music, he has some talent, and that's all that matters. As long as he made good music, that's all that matters. At least he was married, at least he had a wife, and his wife was there by his side when he passed away. So she obviously found something attractive about Biz Markie, and it had to be some reason why they got married. I hope TMZ feel bad now that Biz Markie has passed away, that they regret about talking about he's considered as one of the ugliest rappers of all time. Tell me where you were when you heard that Biz Markie passed away. All right, that's it. See ya.
Yo. I just want to say, rest in power to Biz Mark, my friend. We have so many memories, man. You was in the basement of my grandmother's house when, I wrote Rock the Bells. Used to always hang out and, back in the days and be running around on Queens and Long Island. And I'm glad we got to do what we got to do towards the end, some of the things we got to do, man. And yeah. Love you, bro. And I want to send love to all your, you know, all your fans, millions of fans around the world, your family. Send my love to your family, to your wife, your management. And rest in power, bro. All right? Love you, man. Peace.
Commercial made. It's about driving responsibly, set in New York.
Okay.
New York cab driver, and that song was on his radio. And it's just such a, you know, you can't forget the commercial.
Yes.
That's the first thing I thought about.
Right.
Because you hear that song, and I think Biz was in it as well.
In the commercial.
Yeah.
It's so catchy, and it's like we all know the words, you know, before we even know the name, but so young, far too young, far
For
too
sure.
young to be lost.
May he rest in peace.
Yes. Absolutely. Okay. And we will continue singing those lyrics, that is for sure. We've been singing them all night. Yep. Say, just a friend.
Right. You know. You say he's just a friend.
You say he's just a friend.
Right. Just for you, Biz.
That's for you. Exactly.